Hi everyone, this is ERD Stitches. Welcome to today's tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to achieve this beautiful tote bag. It is so easy to make it. It's beginners friendly, very beginners friendly. If you look at it very well, it has an inner pocket. Look at the inner pocket. You can look, see how it is. Look at the inner with the combination of the lining and the fabric. It's very beautiful. If you are new to my channel and you have not subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel, and also don't forget to put on the notification bell so that you'll be notified anytime I upload a new video. And if my tutorial has been helpful, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Okay then, let's get started. The first thing you need to do is to cut out your fabrics, your interface, your lining, and your handle that you will need to make this beautiful tote bag. Okay, this is my handle. I have two pieces of it and the length is 26.5 inches. This is the fabric I'm going to attach on my lining when I will start my sewing. The length is 3.5 inches while the width is 16.5 inches. This lining is for my pocket and the size is 8 inches width, 8 inches in length. Okay, this is my lining that I'm going to use for this tote bag. I measured it on fold. When I was cutting it, I cut it on fold and the length is 14 inches as you can see, and the width is 16.5 inches. Please make sure when you measure your lining, you measure it on fold. This is my main fabric. I also measured it on fold when I was cutting it, that I didn't cut it in pieces. The length is 17.5 inches while the width is 16.5 inches. You also have to cut the same length of your fabrics on your interfacing because we are going to iron the interfacing on your main fabrics. Now we will start our sewing. What we'll do now is to open our fabrics. The wrong side of our fabrics will face up. Then we pick our interface. Make sure that the side that have the adhesive is facing the wrong side of our fabrics. We take it to your ironing board and iron it on your fabrics. So after ironing our interface on our fabrics, this is what we have. So we are going to keep it aside now. Now we pick up our lining. You open the lining and make sure that the right side of the lining is facing you. Make sure it's facing you, the right side. Then we pick our fabrics. Make sure also that the right side of the fabrics is facing the right side of the lining. Place it together. Then make sure you pin it down before you start sewing. Now once you are done pinning it down, take it to your sewing machine and sew it together. You also have to do the same thing on the other side of the lining. You pick your piece of fabrics, make sure that the right side is facing the right side of the lining, pin it down, and also take it to your sewing machine and stitch it together. Okay, I'm done stitching my lining. This is what I have after stitching it. I've also ironed it and I made sure that the seam allowance is facing my fabrics. So now we take it to my machine and top stitch on it. I will also take top stitch on this side. So after top stitching it, this is how what I have now. Look at it, it's very neat now. Okay, now the next thing we are going to do now is to sew our pocket. If you look at this fabric lining, now you see that I've run a zigzag stitch on it. I just took it to my machine and run a zigzag stitch on all the four edges. So now what I will do now is that I'll have to fold the four edges by 1 cm. I'll just fold in 1 cm on all the four edges. So after folding all the edges in by 1 cm, I will take it to my sewing machine now and top stitch it all around. So this is what we have now after top stitching it round. So what we are going to do now is that we are going to sew it on our lining, but we have to take a measurement of where we want it to be. So we have to measure from the tip of the lining like this. You take in 5 inches. Before you sew your pocket to your lining, make sure you fold your lining into two. Iron it to get a crease line that will indicate the midline. Then take your pocket also, fold it into two. You can use your hand to press it down to form a crease line. Then after getting the crease line on the boat, you make sure that the two crease lines are together on the point to mark 5 inches. Now on that point, you make sure that they are together. Then you now pin it down. Make sure you pin your pocket down on your lining very well. Then after pinning it down, you take it to your sewing machine and stitch it this way, and this way. Make sure that the up is open, because that will be the opening of your pocket. You will not stitch there. Just stitch this way, and also this way. I'm done stitching my pocket. This is what I have after stitching it. So the next thing we are going to do now is we are going to bring our main fabrics and place it side by side with our lining. Open our lining and put it on top of the main fabrics. This is to make sure that they are equal. If by the time you put it together and the main fabric is longer than the lining, or the lining is longer than the main fabrics, what you will do is that you will trim off the excess. As you can see, I'm having excess here. So I'm going to trim off the excess now. But before I do that, I'll have to pin it down together so that it will not shift when I'll be doing that. Then I will trim off the excess. Okay, as you can see, my main fabrics now and my lining are equal. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to fold my lining into two, right side facing each other. Then I will sew the two sides with my seam allowance. Then I will also fold my fabrics into two as well and sew the two sides with the seam allowance. I've done stitching the side seam of my lining and my fabrics, and I've also pressed the side seam apart. So now what we are going to do now is we are going to box the sides. So you have to, what you do is that on the down part of your lining and your fabrics, that's the folded side, you take in 2.75 inches both on the width and on the length. So after marking your 2.75 inches both on the width and the length, you use your ruler and rule it to create a box. That is what we use to shape the base of the bag, to give the base of the bag shape. So now I'm going to use my ruler to connect the points together to form my box. Look, as you can see, I didn't know that this was off camera, but I believe that you understand what I just did here now. Okay, now we are going to cut it out. Sorry, this was off camera, but I believe you understand what I did. I didn't know that it was off camera. I'm sorry about that. This is what I did earlier. I marked 2.75 inches this way. Then I will also come down this way. And also mark 2.75. Then you connect it with your ruler this way. You can see what I'm doing now. After connecting it, you cut it out with your scissors. Please, your measurement should start from your seam line. So what I did on my lining now, I'm going to repeat it on my main fabrics. Okay, now we have to sew it now. Just open it, watch what I'm doing. Make sure that your seam line is together with your crease line at the base. Match it together. Once you match it together, you sew it with your seam allowance. You see the way it is now. The crease line on the base and the seam line has to be together. Then you sew with your sewing allowance. You also do same on your lining. Sew with your sewing allowance, 1 cm or anything that you use for your sewing allowance, you use it to sew. You can see I'm done sewing and this is what I have now. Look at it. This is what I have after sewing it. Now I'm going to turn the main fabrics inside out. So the next thing we are going to do now is we are going to fold it into two to form a crease line on the both side of the bag to get this midpoint. As I'm so you can see what I just did now. You can use your pin to indicate the center or you can mark it with your check. Now from that center, now you fold it on the other side also, you put your pin. So now we have gotten our crease line. We are going to measure where we will put our handle. We take the measurement of 2.75 from that center point, from this center like this. You take it on the both side, 2.75 on the right hand side, also on the left hand side. You take 2.75 like what I just did now. You can see it. I'm taking 2.75 there. From that pin, I will also take 2.75 on the other side. Now after marking it this way, I will bring my handle, my bag handle, from the place I mark, that's where I will fix, place my handle. You can see what I just did. You pin it down. You also turn your handle gently to make sure, this is to make sure that your bag handle is not twisted. You also pin it down. From that point, you mark the 2.75. That's where you pin it from. Then now you take it, I'm going to take it to my sewing machine. Then I will sew it on my fabrics. Then on the other side also, I will also put my handle. I will also take the 2.75. As you can see what I'm doing, 2.75, your mark it. Now I'm going to sew. Make sure you backstitch several times so that your handle will be very firm. Backstitch several times. So this is what I have now after sewing my handle. You can see it. Now I'm going to take my lining. So I will fold my fabrics into two. That's my main fabrics. I'll fold it into two this way. Then I'll put it inside my lining. As if you look at this very well, you see that my main body of my bag, which is the fabrics, is facing the right side of my lining. Right side of my bag is facing the right side of my lining. So now I'm trying to arrange it very well before I will stitch. Make sure that the two side seams are together. These two side seams, the side seam of the lining and the side seam of the main bag, make sure that they are together. You pin it all around. After pinning it all around, so I'm going to take you to my sewing machine now to sew it. Arrange it very well before you sew. You can look at it very well. But when you are sewing, before you sew, make sure that you leave a space where you can turn your bag from. My own, now you can see, I use a different shade of color of pin to indicate where I will open it from. This yellow, these two yellow you are seeing, is where I will open my bag from after sewing. So what it means is that I'm going to start my sewing from one side of the yellow and stop on the other side of the yellow. So when I'm done sewing, I will now open, turn to the right side from this I left here. So after stitching it round, this is what I have. So we are going to turn it to the right side now. So what you have to do now is to dip your hands from that space you left and start pulling your back out from there gradually. I've turned my back inside out. I've also taken it to my ironing board to iron it very well before I will top stitch. Look at the opening. You see the way I iron there. So now I'm going to take it to my machine to top stitch it round. And after top stitching, this is what our bag look like. Very beautiful tote bag. You can give it a try. Thank you for watching till the end of this tutorial. Bye and God bless you.